we're not here to demonize the internet. We're here to understand that the internet is perhaps one of the greatest innovations that has brought the world together and has changed how we live, how we communicate, and how we do things. And so I would love to begin with one of our youngest panelists. We have Rose. Rose, kindly tell us, you are a young person, you're a young adult. What does the internet mean for you?
The internet has actually brought very many aspects to the wrong dimensions world. Like personally for me, in high school, usually when you do projects in subjects, various subjects, you actually need the internet for research. And I can speak for all the high school students here, you know, sometimes the subjects you tend to get a little bit unable to comprehend. And so, like, you're able to start to call on the internet, you're able to actually
even as you spend that time on the internet, I do believe that we have sometimes you feel, are you always safe? Do you always feel safe every time you use the internet, Michael?
But to me, it's something cool. So it's like I feel safe because it's a great discover of information. Also,
right. You've got the cool. You're very passionate about young people, and I see that you work very well with the Kenya Scouts. So tell us, what are some of the dangers that face children or young adults as we begin to that?
The internet is awesome. It's a great new infrastructure for communication. It's a wonderful resource. It's like the road infrastructure which we use to either take us to church or to our graves or to other local accidents. So the internet is great. But just like we have rules on the road, just like we have, you cannot take a child to a foreign land and leave the child there. This space of cyberspace where the children also go, they should also need to be guided and be given rules and introduced to the road. And just like we raise children in our offline world, we need to raise children online. So the threats are not only different, really, right, from what we do in parenting. It's just that there has been a disconnect between parenting in the offline world than it has been in the digital space.
Do you know what catfishing is?
Oh, yeah. There is personas who actually take other people's profiles so that they can impress the person that they'd like to get influenced with. And when that person becomes interested, eventually, like, they will ask you, do you want to meet? They'll be like, do you want to meet here sometime? And the person will give the excuses like, well, I can't, I have this, I have work. You can actually find that you want to talk to a guy, but the real person is actually a lady. Seems like you've been dating a lady online, and that's just weird, it's not right.
What are some of the tips that you have for safety?
I think
that's interesting. How old are you again?
18.
Oh, okay. All right. And you, Jason, you work a lot with young adults with the stars in their open group. How do you encourage them to be open?
First of all, in the
And what to come back to you, because you are the major stakeholder in this type of conversation. And do you know what a digital device contract is?
Thank you. taken to very great heights. But at the same time, we have challenges. We have had the children here verbalize some of the challenges that they go through. But what we want is together, jointly, as young people, as elderly people, as teachers, as trainers, parents, guardians, together we would like to have a safer and better internet. And that's the theme of our celebration today as we reflect on how we can have be safer online.
It's time for us, even as parents, as teachers, we become also technology savvy. We need to train ourselves. We can't afford to just say give it now, but all of us, we need to train and be on board even with our children so that we make them thrive in this digital world, but we don't just survive.
We need to come together. We have to share our experiences. We need to see what ways can be done in order to protect our children, in order to, like today, raise awareness.
With the government continuing to digitize the educational curriculum and learning, the interaction of children with the cyberspace is bound to increase significantly. The cyberspace is becoming more complex, with a lot of criminal activities happening online, and this continues to increase. What does this require of us? And clearly, it involves from all of us to do all we can to safeguard the safety of children who are the most vulnerable.